We're going to do a beef and ale pie. Nice and easy. First of all, our beef that we've got in here, this is just sort of braising state. You could use a little bit of top side, even rump. Add a little bit of butter into here. So our nice hot pan, get it really, really hot to give some lovely colour. Take your steak, this is seasoned flour, pat it down on both sides, and we're just going to colour our beef. Now it's really important that you get lots and lots of colour into here, because this is where your stew will be that lovely dark, lovely rich colour. Put an element of fat onto the piece of meat, but not too much. Because this is a pie and we're going to cover it with a bit of puff pastry, we don't want too much fat just left in there, otherwise that just sits just underneath the layer of puff pastry. So trim off a little bit of fat, all the visible fat really that you find. Some salt, some pepper. We just want to colour this so it's nice and brown really. Use the tongs or a fork, get that lovely rich colour in there. Once they're coloured on both sides, you can see it's raining because my dish is full of water. There we go. Take our steak, place it into our little pot. This is the cooking pot that I'm going to cook it in. We've got our lovely coloured bit of beef. Now into the same pan here, we can increase the flavour and create our lovely liquid. I've got some bacon here, which I bought from the nice butchers just around the corner. If you can't buy bacon in a big slab like this is smoked bacon, and cut it into lardons. You can actually use the little bit of streaky bacon or back bacon that you've got, just cut into small pieces. But good old pieces of bacon like this will give it a lovely flavour. So dice these all up into nice lardons. This can all go into your pan, again with a touch more butter. We can add some onions. I actually add quite a lot of onions into here, nice and sliced onions. I'm going to use white onions, you can use red onions if you want, or shallots. But roughly for about four pieces of steak, add about three onions, so quite a substantial amount of flavour you get from the onions. They can all go in the pan with the bacon, because you want these to caramelise down and still get that nice colour together with your beef. Pop all your onions in. Keep the heat of the pan as well. You want these onions to caramelise. If you reduce the heat of the pan down, these onions will start to stew. You don't get that nice, lovely caramelised colour to them. You can help the colour just by adding a little bit of sugar. Just a touch of caster sugar. Doesn't want a lot, just to help the colour a little bit. We've got natural sugars in the onions anyway, but it'll just stew down. I'm just going to add a little bit of garlic. We need to cook that for about 3 to 4 minutes. So once your onions are nicely caramelised, you see they get nice and soft. You get lovely colour on the onions. This creates lovely flavour and nice colour to our meat. Then we can add our rest of our ingredients, which is some mushrooms, which we're just going to chop these up into quarters. Cut our mushrooms out. About six of them really will be enough. These are just large button mushrooms. Now what I like to add, it's just a few carrots as well. I just think it adds a nice little flavour to it. Again, it's purely optional, you don't have to. But just take a carrot, we'll chop this all up. Again, you could put parsnips, would be quite nice in here as well. Anything that's not too strong, because of the flavour of the ale really needs to come out. Then at this point, you get that lovely caramelisation on the base of the pan from the onions. Then we can take our ale, try and find one that's not too strong. Place that in there, and you more or less deglaze this like you're deglazing a pan with red wine or white wine. We need to allow this to reduce down, and as it's reducing down, it concentrates the flavours, concentrates the natural flavours of the beer, and creates a lovely sauce. So put plenty in. Again, probably a bottle will be enough for all that. And then we can add our beef stock. A bit of beef stock can go in as well. There we go. Two little herbs into there, a touch of fresh thyme, and then a bay leaf. Count the bay leaves in, just one in, so we can take that out later. And then taking your steak that you sealed off earlier, we can place that into our pan. So immerse it in the lovely liquor. And another one, there we go. And then we can cover this over and just gently cook this for for about 45 minutes to an hour. So after about 45 minutes to an hour, we end up with this lovely cooked beef mixture in here. I'll lift this out so you can see the texture of it all. The ale's reduced, it's created this lovely sauce. And then all we can do is take the meat out, place it into the dish that you're going to cook it in. It's the most important thing, because we then recook this in the oven, taking your bay leaf out. So taking your beef out, and then with the sauce that you have left over, spoon this all over your steak. Now make sure you've got plenty of sauce in here as well, because you want it to keep it nice and moist. And pile it up as well. If you've got a dish like this, if you put too little in, the pastry will sink. So put plenty in there. Top it off with your mushrooms. So you've got the steak in the bottom to keep it nice and moist. There we go. And then finally, what you can do is then top this with pastry. Now I'm going to use puff pastry for this, but you could use short crust pastry if you wanted to. I'm going to use the bought-in stuff for this. Again, double thickness. If you've got it in a block, it's much easier. But double thickness, hardly any flour because it will toughen it up. We can then roll this on the old board. And then before you place it on top of the old pie here, take a little bit of egg wash and go around the edge of your little dish. This will help the pastry stick to the sides and to stop it from shrinking down into your pie. Then taking your pastry, even though this is a square piece of pastry on a round dish, put your pastry over the top, like that, and then just crimp the edges, around the edge, with your fingers. This just seals in the pastry, just by nipping the two fingers together, and your thumb, helps it seal onto the dish, right the way around. We got, and then and only then do you trim it around the edge. If you do this too early, the pastry will shrink down into the bottom of your pie. We got a couple of little air holes in there, stops the pastry from being soggy, and then we can take a few more bits of pastry, create a couple of leaves, just cut these out. Again, diamond shaped, any old shape really. Just a few leaves, using the remaining bits of pastry. There we go. Press this out so it's nice and flat. Otherwise, if this is too thick, the leaves will all be out of shape. The knife, you can just mark it quickly all over the top like that. Looking at these leaves, I think it's autumn. And they're dead, but you just take the little leaves like this, touch of egg wash over the top of each one first. There we go. And then this is a little bit of egg wash with not just whole egg, but an egg yolk in here as well. You brush it all over the top. So I find if you just use whole egg on its own, it doesn't give it a nice glaze, whereas if you just use whole egg and egg yolk, it gives it a lovely colour as it cooks. Again, nicely over the top. Make sure you get all inside the little edges. There we go. And then taking your leaves in between the little air holes, you can place these all the way around. And then what we need to do now is then bake this in the oven. Now at home, you'd cook this about 200 degrees centigrade for between 30 and 40 minutes. That's gas mark 6 to 7 to cook the pastry right through. But Catherine's gonna pop it in our little oven. There we go. Might take about 4 hours. And there we have it. Thanks, Catherine. Smells divine. Beef and black sheep ale pie.